Hi. Now in today's lecture we will go through very important test, IDO form test, and it's very important for your exams, for competitive exams, right? IDO form test is given by those organic compounds that contain acyl group or those organic compounds that can produce acyl group upon oxidation, right? Now let's see how acyl group looks like. Most of us, we already know acyl group is CH3CO, where your methyl group is directly attached to carbonyl carbon, right? Or compounds that can form this group upon oxidation, right? Let's see what kind of compounds. If you look at this compound or this part of organic compound, if organic compounds that contain this part, right, on oxidation, they will form this acyl group, right? This is your acyl group where your methyl group is directly attached to the carbonyl carbon, right? Very important. Just remember how acyl group looks like. So if you have acyl group in the organic compound, just remember that it will give you positive IDO form test, right? All compounds that contain this group, right? Any example of compounds that we are aware of? If you remember, we have studied about lactic acid. Right, this is lactic acid. Since it contains this group, right, CH3COH, CHOH, right, this group, right. Now, if lactic acid would be oxidized, it will give you acyl group, right. It will give you a compound that contains acyl group. So, lactic acid will respond positively to IDO form test, right. So, just remember, either organic compound will contain this group or it will contain this group, right, to show positive IDO form test, right. Now let's quickly see what is IDO form test. IDO form test is if you get a yellow precipitate, right, on warming compounds containing this group or this group with iodine and sodium carbonate or sodium hydroxide, right, then this is your IDO form test, right. So compounds that contains CH3CO group, right, or CH3CHOH group, right, on warming with iodine and your sodium carbonate, or in place of sodium carbonate, sodium hydroxide, it will form a yellow precipitate. You will see the presence of yellow precipitate. The yellow precipitate would be the compound IDO form, right? The one that we have studied in previous lecture. So this is the reaction. Right, and these are some of the compounds that will show you positive IDO form test. If you look at this compound contains this group, right, and the rest is this here attached to carbon can be anything, right, and attached to this carbon acyl group can be anything. You just need to look at acyl group, CH3CO group, methyl directly connected to carbonyl carbon, and here you just need to see the presence of the CH3CHOH group, right, because this group on oxidation will give you this, right, acyl group. Now if you look at this compound contains CH3CHOH, so it will respond positively to IDO form test. That means if I warm this compound with iodine and sodium hydroxide, it will give you a yellow precipitate of IDO form, right. Now if I take this compound, this is your acetone, right? How will it respond? This is your acetone. It contains the CH3CHO group. So it will show positive IDO form test. That means it will give you a yellow precipitate on warming with iodine and sodium hydroxide or sodium carbonate, right? This is the reaction. Here we have ethanol, right? We know that ethanol is this compound. CH3CH2OH. Right? So it has CH3 group, CH3CHOH. Right? So it will respond positively to iodoform test. When it is warmed, right, let's say warmed with iodine, sodium carbonate, it will give you yellow precipitate of iodoform. Right? Now, the steps in this reaction, if you want to see how this reaction exactly takes place, if you remember, we have done the formation of iodoform in the previous lecture. The same steps would be followed in this reaction. In this reaction, it will go through oxidation, right, iodination, and then hydrolysis. These three steps. If you talk about oxidation, right, suppose we have sodium hydroxide in this reaction. Sodium hydroxide will react with iodine. It will give you sodium hypoiodide. Right, now sodium hypoiodide will oxidize your this compound, which is your alcohol, which contains this group CH3CHOH. Right, and on oxidation it should give you this. Right, so when this compound is oxidized, it will form CH3CHO. Right, it is verified. This compound on oxidation is giving you acetaldehyde that contains this compound. Right, so this compound, right, which contains this group, right, we've discussed this in the beginning, that compounds that contain this group, which on oxidation will give you compounds containing SiO group, CH3CO group, will show positive iodoform test. Right, so this will show now positive iodoform test. Now, this is your first step, this is your oxidation step of this reaction. Second step would be iodination. Iodination is where your acetaldehyde formed upon oxidation will react with iodine, right, and it will give you this compound. Right, all the three hydrogen atoms will undergo iodination of, or hydrogen atoms of methyl group will undergo iodination, right, to form this compound. This step is iodination. Right, and last step would be where this compound will undergo hydrolysis with sodium hydroxide. Right, it will undergo hydrolysis to give you CHI3, which is your yellow precipitate. Right, so remember, you should know how, what exactly is happening in this reaction. Right, just remember three steps. Oxidation, through the first step we got to know that compounds that contain CH3CHOH group, right, this compound ethanol will form acetaldehyde that contains SiO group. Right, now this will show positive iodoform test as per the definition that we have studied in the beginning. Now this will undergo halogenation with iodine to form this compound. Right, now this compound will undergo hydrolysis to give you iodoform, yellow colored precipitate. Right, so this is your positive iodoform test, which occurs through this step if you talk about chemical reaction. I hope all this is clear. Thanks.